I'm Christine with the Camera Effect Promotions,
and I am joined by the very lovely Rob, who are also from the UK and currently melting in what can only be described as the
first guitar player named
Ian. How are you enjoying the Warped Tour?
He said that it was a nickname that he had.
We love it.
It's our from when he was in high school. It was like a 49 Ford or something. And he calls his car the teenage Bottle Rock. So, yeah, that's how we got the name.
Because we're all so clearly attracted and rugged.
I think someone maybe bought our mixtape.
Do you happen to know how many tattoos you have?
Too much fire in the movie. What is the essential thing that you guys are all obsessed with bringing on tour that you never
lose?
Do you have a upcoming
that, and then like you know those sort of bricks for your phone?
Yeah, we're gonna go to Europe in December with this band called Bones, and we're gonna do a show in Edmonton, Calgary, and September. There's our new drummer.
You don't have a head for a head, right?
Yeah, but literally everyone else. Is
we're gonna go up there and prove to all his friends that he's actually in our band.
So on Warped Tour, what are three must-haves? Every day.
Well, drugs, baby wipes.
So what you're saying is that you've saved the tour by bringing me in.
Yeah, because everyone now wants
to use. On the tour, is there a friend you made that you like to watch every day when you're free?
I really love watching.
That's a cheater. You're the most useless thing
I've ever heard about.
And last time, I watched this band Slight Vendor.
Solid work there.
So yeah,
anything else that you want? The most completely
still kind of making my rounds and trying to take in a new band every day.
Yeah, still like that's a week and a half there.
You did start in Texas, that's quite ambitious.
What's the best part of
Warped Tour? Prepared.
I think just meeting new people and also getting your music out to those people that wouldn't typically hear your band. You know, teenage rock and fans, the Warped Tour really isn't their thing. It's not really a tour that I think that our band's a little unorthodox on the lineup. You know, a lot of our friends are like, dealing with this as a Warped Tour. The whole tour.
I mean,
but it's cool to go out here and
do you think that you got
to people that wouldn't?
Would you say that you are inspired by people
that want
stuff like, or are you very much just about choice? I realize this is a very sensitive question to ask.
Maybe we'll do a concept.
Yeah, and well, also we have a lot of new people that's like
Brexit.
Yeah,
how do you feel about that?
You know, now that I really love your band. I think so.
You can just walk past and see a band you've heard of and it's like, wow, they're great.
Solid. It's cool.
What kind of words would you shout? What would you shout?
Any song
that's a very peachy album, I feel like. That's a very
good answer. Oh yeah, but we can't do the explicit content now.
No, no.
Why not? What would you say is your most
saving that for the album?
Successful
music.
It's on release material, we probably
released. Oh, I see. So a demo. Brexit, the demo.
That was actually, that's how we got it.
Signing Fat Records was cool. Whenever Fatty called, my brother cried, and it was just like a real meaningful moment in our lives.
What are you guys up to in the downtime? Because everyone spends their time.
What is your favorite song you've ever written?
What did you guys do?
It's called Nothing Else Matters, when I was
around.
It's like a spin-off of
We were discussing that we think someone's going to get kind of seriously injured soon.
Lastly, would you have to say to any fans that maybe go through a rough patch?
Charles Dodds over there!
Just trying to creep and rip it, man. You gotta keep the chin up.
Someone's had their phone stolen.
Teenage Brown Rocket. Someone found a dead body here. Something that's helping us to get through it is just to play music together.
An Australian police
through music.
Australian police station. That's the word.